prepping to smoke some ribs. Sunday's my birthday, and I wanted to go ahead and get some barbecue in before it gets too cold and get some practice ready to go for Thanksgiving. So I'm going to start with some ribs and then graduate back up to turkey and stuff like that, because that's what I'll be smoking for Thanksgiving. So it's some turkey. So as you can see, we've got a few ingredients here. We've got some apple juice right there. You're gonna need some gloves. You're gonna need a knife, a sharp knife, cutting board, some foil, and a big bowl for your rub. The next thing you're gonna need for your ingredients is you're also gonna need some paper towels and a spoon. You'll see why we're gonna use the spoon in here in a minute. Then also, what you're gonna need for your ingredients is you're going to need some paprika, some chili powder, some black pepper. Move out the way, yo. Some kosher salt, some garlic. I use some thyme, French thyme, onion powder, some cinnamon, a little bit of white pepper, and some brown sugar. Okay. Now, the first thing that you always do before you start your prep work is you make sure that your area is clean, and then you also make sure that your hands are clean. So we're gonna wash our hands real quick. Some antibacterial soap. And the antibacterial soap, we get just some generic stuff, but it works. So wash it a couple of times here. So the other thing we're gonna do to these ribs tonight is we're going to carve them up St. Louis style. It's not hard to do. Most ribs come with a brisket bone on them. And a little bit of a riblet tip there on the end. And so what you want to do is you want to take that little rib tip thing off of there and make it look a little bit nicer and neater. So that's what we're going to do also. So let's start our prep work by making our rub. So I've got some gloves here. I get these from Harbor Freight Tools. I give a shout out to the Harbor Freight folks. They take care of it for the most part. So I get my gloves going here. Because even though our hands are clean, you always want to have cleanliness in order here, especially if you're serving for other people. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to measure out our ingredients for our rub. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to start with the basic ingredient for any rub. And that's kosher salt. I've got 3 slabs of ribs that I'm going to be rubbing, so I'm going to need plenty of salt, about 4 tablespoons or so of salt, give or take. I don't measure anymore. I just throw the stuff in there. All right, now we're going to use some of this onion powder. You can make your rub ahead of time if you want, but that's fine. Now we're going to do some cinnamon. You don't have to use cinnamon. I use cinnamon because it puts a good flavor on the ribs. You can use whatever you want. Now some black pepper. You want to get not the ground black pepper, but you want to get the closest to freshly cracked black pepper that you can without actually cracking it. I find that this restaurant black pepper works best for what I use it for. Chili powder. That's going to give your rub just a little bit of bite. You don't want to use too much of it either. All right, paprika. And this is sweet paprika that I got from a place called Penzi's. Now we're going to use some garlic. Doesn't take a whole lot of that garlic. Some thyme. Didn't take a whole lot of thyme either. No pun intended. All right. Some ground white pepper. I like to just, there. It doesn't take much of that either. And now, the other ingredient that you'll need the majority of, other than the salt, is brown sugar. Sweet but salty at the same time and spicy as well. Okay. And what you want to do is use a couple of cups of that. I'm using so much of it because we've got three slabs of ribs to rub, like I said earlier. So you want to use plenty of it. All right. I don't think we forgot anything. Let's put that to the side. And now you just want to start mixing up your rub. Do this by hand. Best way to do it. So we've got our rub ready to go. Now what we need to do is get our ribs ready to go here. And I've got three slabs of ribs here from a store called Fairway here in Omaha. These ribs, again, like I said, they're just regular spare ribs. You can get the ribs in a cryovac pack. Okay. Just like this. I'll show this to you guys here. So you get the ribs in a pack just like that. Okay. And what that pack does is it seals the ribs in there, three to a pack. So, again, you're going to get plenty of meat if you get a pack like that. And you can prep them ahead of time and then put them in a deep freezer. So, there's three slabs of ribs in here. They're untrimmed. So what I'm going to do is take them out of this package, wash them and rinse them off thoroughly. Then I'm going to use these paper towels here and the spoon on them next. So what I'm going to try and do here is, as I'm still learning how to do all of this on video here, is I'm going to cut open these ribs with my shears here over the sink, so that it drains right into the sink. Then I'm gonna open up this pack the rest of the way here with these shears here, taking care not to cut into the meat, which is not that hard to do. Now, we got three slabs, one slab, two slabs, and three slabs. So basically, you've got a slab of ribs here. Let me show this to you guys. Hopefully you can see this. So you've got a slab, and you've got a brisket bone or a sternum bone right here. It's a sternum bone. This comes from the chest of the pig. Okay, and you got a bunch of flappy stuff here and a membrane here. And what we're going to do is we're going to rinse off these ribs with cold water. And then we're going to pat them dry. Ready. Now I'm ready to start patting the ribs dry. So I grab a paper towel. What I like to do is I just hold it up by the bone side. And then I just kind of pat it dry a little bit there. You may not get it completely dry, but that's fine. Then I do the other side. Excuse me. Just kind of looking at the ribs here, and I, boom, there we go. And I can throw that away, and I can move on to the next one here. This one's a little smaller than the other two. That's all right. He's going to get eaten anyway. Prep work for this. Now, let me just say this. Let me preface this. I am in no way, shape, or form a professional at this. I'm an amateur. And so, you're going to see some amateurish things that I do. But this works for me and my family. So, that's all I care about. I'm making it taste the way I want it to taste. That's what the guy who taught me how to do all this stuff says. He says, just make it taste like you want it to taste, man. Okay, so now I've got this pan here. I'm gonna put all three slabs on ribs on there. Pow, pow, pow. Alrighty. Now those are out of the way. Now, I got this cutting board here. Let me rinse it off a little bit before I use it again. Already got some blood on it, that's fine. Now, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna take this, a slab of ribs, and we're gonna square it off. And all you're gonna do when you square that off is you're making St. Louis style ribs. We're gonna get rid of a little bit of this fat here. Not a lot, just a little. This little end here. Kind of dangles over there. We're going to get rid of that too because it's just not necessary. And we're going to square it up and get rid of the rib tips, and we're going to pull off the membrane. And when you see St. Louis style ribs in the store, that's what you're buying. So we're going to locate the big bone here because there's a small little teeny tiny bone right there. And we're going to trim that off there. Now, this is, it's still good meat. Don't get rid of it. Okay? Toss it to the side there. Alrighty. So we're going to in there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to trim up right here. So let me turn this way. Squaring up that right there. Oh yeah, I can feel that in there. This is probably the hardest part of your whole job right here, is trimming up these ribs and making them St. Louis style. Good job, Mr. Spoon there. So, this is a rib tip, okay? That's a rib tip. I've got a bunch of these out in the freezer, so I need to cook them up soon. But you can put them in beans and stuff like that. But what a lot of people do is they trim this piece of meat off, the ribs here, and then they smoke this, and then they cut them up into little tips, and then they serve them up with barbecue sauce, and that makes up a rib tip. Okay? That's good eating. We don't want to throw that away. Okay? So basically, there we go. We've got a carved up St. Louis style rib there. That's a little piece of bone we're going to get rid of there. Now, we can get rid of this little piece of gelatinous goo here. You don't want that on there either. It doesn't harm anything, like I said, if you're just serving it for your family, but from what I hear, if you're doing a competition, you don't want to serve that to a judge. That's fat. We want to get rid of that. And we're going to get rid of this too here. Just a little bit. All right. There we go. Now, try not to step on my new microphone here. Now, the next step that we have to do, and the final step in the carving and the prep work of this thing here, is we're going to get rid of this too. There's this little diaphragm flap here. But you know what? Before we do that, let's do this. Because we're not gonna get rid of that either. So what you want to do at this point is you want to take a paper towel, you maybe fold it in half like this, and then just do this like that. You're gonna take this spoon, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna run under the edge of one of these bones here on the back. Because what you're doing now is you're getting that membrane off of there. And once you can grab a good hold to it, take that paper towel and just start yanking on it. But you're not trying to rip it, because you're trying to get the whole thing off of there. You guys can see that. Boom, pow, one shot right there. Now we've got this nice little flap of skin there. We can cut that off of there too. Putting our ribs right along the edge, our knife right along the edge of the ribs. Pow. See, there we go. Could put that in some stew meat too. You know? All right. So now we have a slab of St. Louis style ribs right there. Ain't that nifty? And I'll do the other ones the exact same way. All right, so I've got all the ribs are trimmed up and everything, and this is what they look like. Nice and square. All the tips are in a bag over here. Tips and pieces. Yeah. Throw that in a pot of beans or something. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these ribs and I'm going to rub them down with my rub. But first, before we do that, let's do a couple of different explanations here. So last time I did this, I did some experimentation on different types of things to put on them. There's a place here in Omaha called Old World Oil and Vinegar. It's run by a little couple, real nice little couple, and they have really good olive oils and vinegars. Now, this particular olive oil is chipotle, and I put this on the ribs the last time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that on the ribs as well. I'm also going to put some mustard on there. Now, the last time I did this, I swore against doing mustard before when I first started learning how to do this. I was like, why people put mustard on their stuff? And then I did it the last time. I was like, wow, you know, I was amazed. So just regular yellow mustard is what we're going to use. So that's what we're going to do. And we're going to put that on our ribs. So first things first, excuse me, we're going to do our yellow mustard. And you will not taste, you don't taste this stuff. And rub this in there. You're This is what the gloves are for. Your hands are gonna just get nasty, so there's no way around it. So get all the sides of the ribs. Take one hand. Come over here so you guys can see. And just start rubbing your rub into the ribs. You know what? I just learned a new technique that I'm going to do. Now, some of it's going to come off overnight because I'm going to put these in the fridge overnight so that the rub can really penetrate my ribs here. And that's fine, but you don't have to do that. You can do it, you know, a couple hours before you start smoking your ribs or whatever. So that is on there pretty good. I'm going to flip this over to the other side. Now this side doesn't get as much, okay? This side doesn't get as much. But I'm going to go ahead and put, come on, mustard. Put a little mustard on there. Rub it in there. Get the meaty part. That's the part you want to get right there. A handful of your rub, put it on there. Like I said, this side you don't have to get that much because, you know, it's the bottom side of the ribs, and you know, you're more worried about the top side where the meat is. Yeah, meat. All right, so that's in there. Now you're probably wondering, why the foil? Why is there foil here? Well, I'm going to show you. I like to work smarter, not harder a lot of times. So, therefore, what I'm going to do is I take that. College degree's working out good. All right, so you take that, you fold it over. Now, I always wrap it with two because it's going to lose moisture during the night in the fridge. So therefore, I'll just put that in there. One down, two to go. So this one, I'm going to use the olive oil and the mustard. So let me wash my hand off here. I'm going to pop open this Chipotle olive oil here. These folks are really, really nice people. And the store is awesome. You can go in there, you can sample the vinegar, you can sample the olive oil, and it just, it tastes so good. My wife uses this garlic olive oil that's really doggone good. She puts on everything now. All right. That smells wonderful. Okay, so let me back this up just a tad bit here. I'm gonna make that bit of a mess. And I'll just pour some of that on there. Put that on there. I'm gonna rub that in to my meat. I won't put this on the back side because there's some on the. That's gonna be wonderful. As you can tell, there's already some on the backside. It's olive oil. I'm still going to put some mustard on there, though, just to make sure that the rub sticks to the meat. So that olive oil and the mustard is mixing in together. Now, just start spreading this all over there, just like so. Because the goal is when we get up in the morning, we're going to, whatever rub we have left, we're going to put, you know, because the rub's going to kind of liquefy overnight in the fridge. And I've got a couple of meetings to go to at the church in the morning. And so what's going to happen is it's gonna kind of liquid. Look at that. Look at that. Olive oil is right on the back. I ain't gonna do nothing on there. Let's put some mustard on there. A lot. Rub it down. Just like so, getting that meaty part there. Like before. A handful of this stuff. And you just rub to your heart's content. Rub it, rub it, rub it. There we go. We've got three slabs of ribs that are going to be ready to go for the morning. Well, tomorrow when I get home from my meeting. And we have little to no rub left here, which is fine. We didn't make a huge mess. Cleaned up as we went along. And these will be ready to smoke tomorrow. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you all how I start my fire. So I use these little, what would you call these things? These, I use these Weber charcoal starters. They're really good to use. And what they do is they burn at all times, and they burn in cold weather. They burn when they're wet and everything else. And all you do is you get one of those, which is a charcoal chimney. You get yourself a charcoal chimney, and then you put your coals in that, and then you put one of these Weber things up underneath there. And then what happens is the fire comes up, and then it heats up your charcoal. And then that way, what you can do is you can put it into your smoker or whatever grill or whatever the case that you're using. So I'll show you all how I do that with the charcoal. Oh, another thing that I have is I have a charcoal basket that I made years ago. And all I do is I put the charcoal in this and fill it up, start my charcoal on one side. I guess my little shadows start barking at me here. I put the charcoal on one side and then it fills up. And again, I put the charcoal on one side. I put the lit charcoal from the chimney, you know, on one side, and then it just burns all the way through. If I set this up the right way, I can get a good burn for a good 4 to 6 hours without even refueling it. So that's what I'm going to do right now. So let me put some stuff to the side here. This is one of the messier parts of the job here. And I've got this little ash catcher kind of a thing underneath there. It's just a steel bucket that I use. So what I'm going to do, and today I'm using the good one lump charcoal. I've got the bag upside down because you open it from one side here. Okay. Flip this up the other way around here. Yeah, there we go. So what I have here is a bag of lump charcoal. Now, lump charcoal, what it does is it's just basically wood. All charcoal is wood in some way, shape, or form. But lump charcoal is wood that has been put into a kiln or a retort, and all of the fluid, the water, driven out of the wood, and then you get charcoal. If you want to see what it looks like when it's made, you can go on YouTube and check it out. Charcoal briquettes. Charcoal briquettes are a little bit different because they're made in a mold, and they're made using sawdust. So the good one lump charcoal, I get that. You can get that from just about anywhere. The charcoal that I have not used in a while is called Ozark Oak. And again, it's the best brand that I've ever used. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put that into my basket. I'm going to fill up my basket and get it ready to go here. Alrighty, So let's go ahead and get this charcoal in the basket. I would recommend using gloves to do this, but since I'm just going to be putting it in for some charcoal and I'm not going to be doing it for a long, I'm not going to be doing it for a long period of time, I'll just go ahead and use my bare hands. So, you want to get charcoal that has plenty of large pieces. See that? So that's all on one side there. And then what I do is I move all of the coals, the unlit, to one side, and I pile it up on one side where I get rid of one of the corners, basically. It's like that. So this is my lean corner over here. Because in that, I'm going to mix some wood too. So, since my airflow goes from here, from this way to this way, I'm just going to put my basket in there just like that. Now, these things go here and here. And put the chimney on the top. Put the chimney on the top there. Shut up, dog. Now, let that piece go. There you are. Get over here. Get over here. It's a good sized piece too. Put that in there. Now, I'm gonna light this up. I'm gonna light you up too, buddy. He's mean, he's mad at me. All right, so all you do, getting these extra pieces here, is, I bet you if I throw him a bone, he'll love me. Is you just light this, and it lights. People use these camping too. I never thought I'd use stuff like this, but I swear by these things now. So now, all I'm going to do is I'm gonna let that go and let it light itself up there. Ooh, that's a good one. Other thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to open up my dampers on my smoker, because when I get ready to use it, I want them to be all the way open. So now we're ready to go with that. So that'll go. And you can see, and as you can tell, it's going really good now. It'll build a nice fire up in there. Those coals will get nice and hot, which gives us time to get our ribs ready to go. They're already ready to go. I just need to take them out of the smoker. I mean, take them out of the foil. Those dogs are throwing me off. Take them out of the foil, and then we'll be ready to go. So one of the things that I had to do was I had to re-record the audio on this. So what's happening here is I am, you have to figure my voice. My voice is hoarse from doing this barbecue. So what I'm doing is I am going to re-rub the ribs. They've been sitting in the refrigerator all night long, overnight. It's the evening time of the next day. It's a Saturday, the 2nd. Here I'm showing you the parquet I'm going to be squeezing and then the rub that I'm going to be spreading. But the parquet is for after the ribs have been on the smoker for a long time, 3 hours actually. So now what I'm about to do is unwrap these ribs and show you how this all looks. So right now I'm washing my hands, and I'll go ahead and put some gloves on and show you guys what the ribs are going to look like after I take them out of the foil. So now, the next step that I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be reapplying rub to my slabs of ribs here. So in a moment, you'll see me putting the gloves on like I spoke of earlier. And of course, there you see the parquet. So as I put my gloves on here, let me just kind of explain what's going to happen here. Since the ribs have been in the smoker overnight, they've lost a lot of moisture during the rub process. Since there's a lot of sugar and salt in the rub, it swaps moisture out with the moisture that's in the ribs, and it passes in the flavor of my rub. So as you can tell momentarily, as I open up this slab of ribs here out of the foil, you'll see that there's quite a bit of runoff from the ribs after an overnight session in the rub. And that's to be expected, and that's normal. So I'll put my foil off to the side there. Remember, I wrapped it in two different layers of foil, and as you can tell, again, like I said, there's a lot of moisture that has run off, and it's still running off there. So you just move that to the side there, and then you just unwrap the other two, just like so. The other thing too is you're gonna use a lot of foil for this kind of a process, because the foil, you know, it's a really important tool. So there's two slabs, and I'm unwrapping the third slab now. These smelled wonderful when I unwrapped them, and they weren't even cooked yet. So, and as you can tell, they've got great color. That the paprika has given them a kind of a redder color. And so now what I'm going to do, as you can see there, there's the three slabs still cut up. I'm just cleaning up a little bit after myself there, so that way I can stay out of trouble with my my bride. Is I'm going to grab my rub after I squash on that foil a little bit and do a little cleanup work there with my hands here, because it's just easier to kind of clean up as you go. So I'm grabbing the rub, and it's, since it's brown, it's got a brown sugar in there, it's going to kind of clump up on you, which is fine. And so you just pour a little bit on top of your ribs, just like so. And then you just clump up, you get rid of those big clumps of brown sugar, and you just rub more rub into your ribs. And as you go, and you need more rub, you just put some in your hand. This is what you use the gloves for. And you spread more along your ribs. And so I'm going to do that for all three slabs. And I didn't get the back, the underside of that, because I just really didn't, you know, it wasn't really a big deal, since the underside's not where your flavor is going to be at. So I'm doing the second slab now. Just like that. And then I'll do the third slab. Just like this. That stuff was kind of a pain to get out of there because it had clumped up so much. But it's brown sugar, so you don't have to worry. You can heat it up in the microwave a little bit, and it'll be a little bit more manageable for you. If you do that, just do it in a bowl, though. So now I've got my three slabs of ribs re-rubbed. So now I'll ensure that I have a decent crust on the outside of them. There we go. The little white flecks that you see, some of it's onion powder that's kind of clumped up, and some of it's actually the cloves of garlic that's minced up. Now what you can see is my charcoal chimney, and it is blazing hot. I really didn't expect it to get that hot so fast, but it really is burning up there. So as you can tell, it's ready to go. Now you just have to be careful with what you're doing. Obviously you're playing with fire here, so you can't really tell what I'm doing, because I was trying to hold the camera at the same time and I just didn't have time to, you know, set up. And I dropped the coal on my deck, and it was just, you know, it was cold, so it doesn't take long for your deck to catch on fire. But, you know, since it was so cold out, I didn't worry about it. That's kind of reckless, but, you know. So as you can tell, you can see my fire there. It's burning really, really hot. And so all I'm going to do is close up the lid there. And then I check my dampers, open up the dampers all the way. There's my temperature gauge. And there's some hot coals in there at the bottom there that fell through. So now, that's all I had to do there for the smoker to get it going. And I think it took maybe 20 minutes for it to get up to temperature. You can't really tell, but it's already starting to climb up there. So my smoker, it doesn't take long. It's a little backyard doohickey that I got from Lowe's, you know, years ago, and it serves its purpose. So one day I'll be like the big boys and have my own big smoker with a logo and everything. So alrighty. So I've put some wood on. My temperature gauge is right at about 230, which is the optimal temperature for my smoker. So I'm going to go ahead and put these ribs on the smoker. I got to do this rather quickly, because if not, I'll lose a bunch of heat. These are shorter, so I can get away with stacking these up next to each other. Go. I got one more thing I got to do, and that's add some water to a drip pan. Alrighty, so now I just need to add some water. And you see, I don't know if you guys can see this, that water's not that hot. It's that cool out here. So here we go. Let me add some water. To my drip pan. At least I have to get to my water pan. It's 9 o'clock at midnight. I should be able to check these and see how they're doing. So until midnight, I got 3 hours to do what I want to do. Okay, so now I've got these ribs here. They've been on the smoker for 2 hours so far, And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start to do the second phase of my rib smoke. And that's going to require me to take these ribs and we're going to put some brown sugar, some butter, margarine, and some honey. On the ribs here. And this part you won't, you know, need a lot of the glove there. All you need is just a little bit of brown sugar. Put that down. Turn these bad boys over. Shake up this parquet, squeezable margarine. Okay. And then the honey goes on next. Okay. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip this over on top of that and repeat the process. Spread a little bit of brown sugar on the top. Some more of the parquet. And some more of this honey. A sweet but spicy rib here. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and tint it up like so. Make sure you guys can see what I'm doing here. Take just a smidge of apple juice. It doesn't require a whole lot. That should be enough, I'm thinking. Last time I did this, I made them. They were good. They were really good, but they were falling off the bone. Go ahead and just seal that up so that those juices can stay in there. Another piece of foil. Seal that up nice and tight. That's ready to go. It is officially my birthday. Smoking ribs for the family on my birthday. I am one world-class pops and hubby to be smoking ribs on my birthday. Hope y'all remember this, girls and my wifey. Just up a little. Again, like I said, it doesn't require a whole lot of juice. Just a smidge here and there. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to duplicate what I did the first time. Well, the second time I did these kind of ribs. So now we've got three slabs that are going to go back on the smoker. It is 12:15 now, and all I'll need to do is I'll just put these out there for another couple hours. So it's gonna be about 2, and this should be done. Alrighty, well, we're done with our smoke. I've gone ahead and pulled these ribs off the smoker, and they smell wonderful. Look at that. Look at that bone. Came right on off there. Okay, so this is the difficult part here, because these suckers are trying to fall apart on me here. See, if we zoom in there, there's a the bones are pulled away from the ribs really well. Let me go on and get a knife here. Into these bad boys here. Okay. My smoke ring to it. See the smoke ring there? Right there. Up. Look at that. That looks wonderful. Alright, I'm going to eat one of these. And oh my God. That's really good. So those are smoked barbecue ribs, St. Louis style. Great taste, great texture, great color. And this video will be edited on YouTube, and I'll put it out there for all to see. Have a blessed day. A happy birthday to me. God bless.